All right, so here I am at Walmart. I just went ahead and get my battery tested. It's the Everstart Max 3-year free replacement warranty, 750 volt cranking amps, and group size 34. 521. Walmart actually gives you a printout on the sheet right here. the rating, what it started at, and let's see, elapsed time. I believe it says 4 minutes. That's correct. 5 hours, 2.2. And battery's good. Battery meets or exceeds specs, and the best. Test. Alright, we're good. So let's go ahead and put this up there. What you want to do, before you ever put a battery in, you want to get this thing. It's called a terminal brush, or a battery brush. Let's see here. Inside is for the leads. Connectors, and the other side right here is for the terminals, the battery terminals themselves. What I like to do is go ahead and give this a good just a good brushing. Sometimes you can go backwards on the other side of the brush. Sometimes you can go backwards. I recommend doing this every time that you change the battery out or take it out. That'll keep the connectors clean. Goes back in that little cap just like this for storage. And you can see the terminals are nice and shiny now. That's what you want inside. You want the connections to be shiny. Now, I don't go and put dielectric grease on this, and the reason why I don't put anything on this is because if you're in a dusty environment, the dust is going to stick to the contacts. this was called percussive mechanics when you use a blunt force object. Make sure your terminals are completely seated on here. And these terminals are 10 millimeters. Sure we don't crush this terminal here. Alright, that's good. And now this one. Just make sure that you never connect these two with a metal object, or a conductive object I should say. Holding my finger on that ring terminal to keep it in place. All right, that's definitely a solid connection. If for some reason you ever have an issue with this clamping down tight enough on your terminal, you can always put a screw, not into the battery, but into the terminal and of the connector. Just make sure you don't drill into the case. Bad news. Alright, so that's it. Battery's on. Oh, and I do have this little mounting bracket. You want to make sure that you put these back on here, this battery holder, because you do not want to turn your battery into a projectile if you ever hit something. And trust me, if you do not have this battery secure, or anything secure for that matter, in your vehicle, and it rolls or impacts something, whatever direction it's going, that's where all of the stuff that's not bolted down is gonna go. So I did one time, had a collision, and the battery was not secure. And the battery went into the radiator. Alright, so this is a 13 millimeter. Alright, so I used a 13 millimeter ratcheting combination wrench, and I used a 10 millimeter. Ratcheting combination wrench to remove the battery terminals on this 2005 Dodge Grand Caravan. But the same principle applies, and I use a pry bar to remove the terminals. If you do something like this, or you open your hood, it's always a good idea to check the rest of your fluids. So we'll go ahead and check our brake fluid. Questionable. Looks dirty, but the level is good. Automatic transmission fluid. We should always do this when it's running, but we can do it now and do it check before. Wow, that's kind of high. And this is the reason why I say check it when it's running, is because it'll suck the fluid in. To the torque converter and through the system. All the way down, all the way out. And okay, for the level. So right there. I mean, it could be there, but it's probably there. We're good. If you can, wipe up the residual. We checked the engine oil, the transmission fluid, which we need to check when it actually starts running. We checked the brake fluid, power steering fluid, engine coolant, overflow reservoir, actual engine coolant, and washer fluid. Levels right there, so we're good. Alright. Just always do a quick check on everything. Make sure everything looks good. Pulleys, belts, cables look good. Make sure nothing has decided to live in your vehicle or make a nest. And check underneath to see if there's any leaks. Or anything hanging down below your vehicle. All right, that's it. Peace.